5 mystery infections have contact tracers baffled, with health authorities calling for people who live and work around St Kilda to urgently get tested. It comes as the Premier slammed anti-Semitic attacks directed at those who attended an illegal engagement party nearby.
Stage 4 restrictions are back, so is the curfew, but the testing numbers aren't reflecting the city's dire situation.
We're not seeing testing rates high enough, and we are concerned that there are cases here that we do not yet know about.
31,500 test results were completed in the past 24 hours, and 24 new cases were found. Only 14 had been in isolation, while the outbreak from an illegal engagement party has swelled to 6 and given way to hate speech online.
Anti-Semitism is unacceptable and evil, and we have a zero tolerance approach to that in our state.
We're the ones who will deal with that matter. We've said we will deal with that matter. We're working with the people who were involved in those breaches.
5 cases are unlinked.
These cases aren't linked by age. They're not linked by faith. They aren't all in the same book club. They're not all on the same footy club. The only thing they share is geographic proximity.
It's prompted health authorities to urge anyone living in Port Phillip, Glen Ira and Bayside to get tested. The new mystery cases have health authorities baffled because while they're all connected to the St Kilda area, they share nothing else in common, which means the virus is circulating in this community undetected.
These cases got the virus from somewhere. The virus is circulating in those geographic areas of Melbourne.
Less than 24 hours into Melbourne's curfew, police say early indications suggest people are complying, but the impact of the tougher restrictions are already showing.
The awful consequences of lockdown are apparent to everyone, myself maybe more than most. And if I could choose otherwise, I would choose otherwise.
Candice Wyatt for 10 News First.
And Candice Wyatt joins us live now. Candice, Victoria has reached a vaccination milestone.
Well, this is the good news, Jen. Almost 80,000 vaccines were put into the arms of Victorians yesterday, which is a new record for the state, second only to New South Wales, which managed to vaccinate just over 106,000 people. So to date, around 4 million Victorians have received a jab, and around a quarter of those have received both doses, which means they're now fully vaccinated. Now, nationally, our figures are picking up as well. 15.6 million Australians have now received a jab, and 279,000 of those were given in just the past 24 hours alone. Now, the Prime Minister says that equates to around 200 doses per minute. And in some further good news, Jen, those extra 1 million Pfizer vaccines that Australia managed to secure from Poland have arrived in the country today, and those will start being divvied out to the states, including Victoria, shortly.
Okay, thank you very much, Candice.